Science, discoveries, inventions propels us towards understanding the laws of nature and how to bring well-being and comfort into human lives. From the discovery of fire and the invention of wheel, we came a long way where advanced artificial intelligence is just knocking at our doorstep. But the price of knowledge doesn't come so easily. It reflects years of hard work and dedication which has been put in. In this journey, there have been countless sacrifices of lives, pioneers in their field who gave their lives well in the course of their work. In this video, let's go through 10 such personalities who sacrificed their lives for science. Carl Wilhelm Scheele. Carl Wilhelm Scheele was a German chemist born in 1742. He has an important place in history as a discoverer of respiratory gases. Despite this, his contributions have often been overshadowed by those of Joseph Priestley and Anton Lavoisier. Scheele was slow to publish his discovery, and therefore Priestley is rightly recognized as the first person to report the preparation of oxygen. Scheele was enormously productive in other areas of chemistry and discovered 7 new elements and many other compounds. He had the habit of tasting the chemicals and compounds which he had discovered. Cumulative exposure to arsenic mercury led to his death at the early age of 43. Elizabeth Fleischmann Ascham. Elizabeth was an American radiographer and an X-ray pioneer. She opened California's first X-ray photography laboratory in 1896, merely 1 year after Roentgen's discovery of X-rays. She was a single Jewish woman of 30 when she learned the trade and opened her lab. Continuous exposure to the harmful rays took its toll on her. She had to amputate her right arm, and within 10 years of opening her lab, she succumbed to the radiation poisoning and died. Louis Slotin. Louis Slotin was a Canadian physicist who took part in the Manhattan Project. He was present on December 2, 1942, when Chicago Pile, the world's first nuclear reactor, went live. Slotin developed a reputation as a skilled bomb assembler, especially capable of putting together the bomb's firing mechanism. On May 21, 1946, he was in the process of conducting critical experiment to teach his colleague. The experiment involved bringing together two beryllium-coated half-spheres around a plutonium core without allowing the two halves to touch. Slotin was using a screwdriver, which accidentally slipped. A bright blue flash filled the room. Slotin threw his body to shield his fellow scientists, receiving 1,000 rads of radiation, far over the lethal dose. He died 9 days later, after the effects of radiation poisoning. Karen Waterhan. Karen Waterhan was a professor of chemistry at Dartmouth College. Karen was pipetting a small amount of dimethyl mercury when she accidentally spilled a drop or two on her latex glove. She immediately followed safety protocols, but the damage had already been done. Within a few days, her speech began to slow, and sight and hearing was impacted. She then was diagnosed with severe mercury toxicity. In early February 1997, just 3 weeks after the appearance of symptoms, she descended into coma. She remained in a vegetative state until she died on 8 June 1997. Sieur Fremenet. French inventor Fremenet attempted to create a scuba diving breathing device that would recycle the air that was exhaled. This was the first self-contained air device. Unfortunately, Fremenet died from lack of oxygen after being in his own device for 20 minutes. Thomas Andrews. Thomas Andrews was a British businessman and shipbuilder. He was the managing director and head of the drafting department of shipbuilding company Harland and Wolff in Ireland. He was the main designer of both RMS Olympic and Titanic, which upon completion were the largest and most luxurious liners of their time. When the Olympic undertook its first voyage, Andrews was aboard. He was also a passenger when Titanic sailed its first voyage. After the ship struck an iceberg on April 14th, Andrews assessed the damage and determined that the ship will sink. He helped in the evacuation. Andrews was last seen in the first-class smoking room. The Titanic sank on April 15th at 2:20 a.m. Andrews' body was never recovered. Praise Lawson Hunley. Hunley was a Confederate marine engineer during the American Civil War who developed hand-powered submarines. One submarine, H.L. Hunley, was named after him, and he decided to test the submarine during a routine exercise. The vessel sank, and all the 8 men, including Hunley, was killed. Franz Reichert. Franz Reichert was an Austrian-born French tailor. He was also known as the Flying Tailor. He became fixated on developing a suit for aviators that would convert into a parachute and allow them to survive a fall. He announced to the press in 1912 that he finally received permission to conduct an experiment from the Eiffel Tower to prove the value of his invention. But he died in the process. Max Valier. Max was an Austrian rocketry pioneer. He helped found the German Society for Space Travel that would bring together many minds that would later make spaceflight a reality. In 1928, he worked with Fritz von Opel on developing rocket-powered cars and aircraft. By the late 20s, they were focusing their effort on liquid-fueled rockets. He performed the first test drive of a rocket car with liquid propulsion. Valier was killed less than a month later when an alcohol-fueled rocket exploded on his test bench in Berlin. Marie Curie. Marie Curie was the first woman to win a Nobel Prize in physics and then in chemistry. She became the first woman to claim Nobel's honors twice. Her efforts led to the discovery of radium and polonium. Prolonged exposure to radium caused her death at the age of 66 in 1934. Curie's notebooks are stored away. It will remain radioactive for another 1,000 years. It is said that science progresses after star researchers die. The loss is a misfortune, but their sacrifice were not in vain, as it adds to the expanding of horizons of science. Thank you.